and threats to him. The FBI has been looking closely at these threats, especially among some of the white supremacist groups. Gene Reserve has more on this story. Gene?
Well, since last summer, people have been arrested for threatening President Obama in Colorado, Tennessee, and just last week in Wisconsin. The Secret Service won't comment on the volume of threats, but others will tell you it's way up.
During the inauguration, security around President Obama was unprecedented. Expect that to continue.
The fact that he's an African American, the fact that we're at war, the fact that the economy is pretty poor. You're right. All of those things come together to create a very, very tense environment for the Secret Service.
A bulletin issued earlier this month by the FBI and Department of Homeland Security said Mr. Obama has been the focus of voluminous threat-related reporting since announcing his candidacy, and the number of threat reports has increased since his election. The websites and chat rooms of white supremacists have seethed with hate.
The idea of a black man in the White House is an utter anathema. They think that this represents this sort of stealing of the nation which they imagine as having been created as a kind of Christian white entity.
The FBI says it is watching the chatter, looking for threats.
I think we've been very, very aggressive in looking at the potential of any white supremacy or domestic terrorism group to take some sort of action.
But the dangers to President Obama are not all homegrown. In November, Al-Qaeda's number two, Ayman al-Zawahiri, accused Mr. Obama of standing with the enemies of Islam. In his inaugural speech, President Obama extended a hand to moderates in the Middle East.
To the Muslim world, we seek a new way forward, based on mutual interest and mutual respect.
His first phone calls were to leaders in the region. But some analysts believe President Obama's efforts to co-opt extremists may inflame them and provoke them to action against him. The outpouring of emotion for the Obama presidency may make him a target of another group, the psychologically dangerous. John Hinckley, for instance, who shot President Reagan, was mentally ill.
And people who plot on their own so-called lone wolves are the most difficult to detect because often they don't share their plans with anyone. Wolf, back to you.
All right, Gene, thank you. Very disturbing stuff.